Here is example 32, statics. In order to hold a television tower erect, the resultant loading exerted on end D must be 20 kN in the negative Z direction. So the resultant should be negative 20 kN. That's R or RZ. Determine the tensile force in each cable required to accomplish this. So this is the television tower. These are the three cables. So let's solve this. I'll present the solution by expressing each tension force into vector form. So the magnitude will be denoted by FDA, FDB, and FDC respectively for these cables. So for FDA, it is directed down, negative along Z, negative K, negative Z component, to the left, negative Y component, backward, negative X component. So all components of FDA will be negative. So negative 10I, negative 30J, negative 85K, then distance is square root of 10 square plus 30 square plus 85 square. So therefore, FDA is equal to magnitude divided by square root of 10 square plus 30 square plus 85 square times the quantity negative 10I, negative 30J, negative 85K. Simplifying, FDA in vector form is FDA times quantity negative 0.1103i minus 0.3308j negative 0.9372k. Next, FDB, it is directed down and forward. So the X component is positive, the Z component is negative, the Y component is zero. So FDB is its magnitude divided by square root of 20 square plus 0 square plus 85 square times the quantity 20i minus 85k. Simplifying, FDB is equal to FDB quantity 0.2290i minus 0.9734k. Then finally, FDC, it is directed down, negative along Z, to the right, positive along Y, 20, then backward, negative along X, 20 also. So FDC is its magnitude divided by square root of 20 square plus 20 square plus 85 square times the quantity negative 20i plus 20j minus 85k. So expressing in decimal, FDC is magnitude of FDC negative 0.2233i plus 0.2233j minus 0.9488k. So summation for SESX is 0 because the resultant is directed in the negative Z direction. It implies X component of resultant 0, Y component of resultant 0, and the Z component of resultant is negative 20, which is also the resultant. So R is negative 20K. That means Rx is 0, and it is equal to the X component of FDA, negative 0.1103 FDA. The X component of FDB is 0.2290 FDB. Then plus the X component of FDC, which is negative 0.2233 FDC equals 0. Call that equation 1. Ry equals 0 equals negative 0.3308 FDA. Then there's no 0 FDB plus 0.2233 FDC equals 0. Then Rz equals negative 20 equals negative 0.9372 FDA, negative 0.9734 FDB, then negative 0.9488 FDC. Call that equation 3. Solving these three equations simultaneously will give us the values of the tensile force in FDA, FDB, and FDC as these values. 4.742 kilonewtons. FdB is 9.134 kilonewtons, and FdC is 7.025 kilonewtons. Now for your part, here is the problem. Solve the problem, this same problem, for the case where an additional force of 1 kilonewtons is applied to the tower at point D in the positive y direction. So meaning to say there is a force additional here, 1 kilonewton in this direction, then solve the problem again. And the same condition that the resultant is 20 kilonewtons in the negative z direction. And show that these are the answers. FdA is 6.757 kilonewtons, FdB is 8.649 kilonewtons, and FdC is 5.532 kilonewtons.